Hi everybody, it's Jack Bergeron again, and welcome back to GTA 4. Where we left off is Niko just got off the boat and literally starting already getting pushed around by Roman. So without further ado, let's just jump right into this. Unread message. Shit, need help, come to the depot, quick, man, Roman. Of course. So just go right to the depot again, and let's do this. Already had the car from last time, so let's do this. Do I need to bother putting the? Oh, it's literally just around the corner, so I'm gonna do it anyway. So. I've decided, though, like, I'm also going to try and do some online multiplayer videos for, like, Call of Duty or something. Let me know what you guys think about that if you're interested in that kind of stuff. Otherwise, I don't know if, like, I'll do it. It's just an idea. Yeah, so literally, in my view, Roman is one of the most useless NPCs in a game, next to Ashley from Resident Evil 4. So for the first few missions, you can literally just use his taxis and just like go on a rampage with him if you felt like it. But literally, most of the beginning missions are going to be kind of slow moving. It's not until like a little bit later when the gameplay starts getting a bit more exciting. But aside from that, the story itself is really good. I love this game. But I'm sorry for the really bad video quality. I'm just kind of recording this right off the TV, so.
Get in, ladies.
Hey, Niko, thanks for coming. I should have known Roman would find some excuse not to turn up. This is Michelle.
Hi, how are you? I live on Rotterdam Hill up on Mohawk Avenue. You know where that is?
Then I go back to Michelle's apartment.
Not exactly what I expected.
Niko, you know what? You need someone to show you a good time. Michelle, how about you?
Mallory, stop it!
Come on, you guys. You're both single. You're adults. Take a number, Niko.
Hey, I'd like to see you again, Niko. You look like that kind of guy I want to get to know.
You look like you just jumped off the boat, Niko. Handsome man like you should get some new threats.
I think he looks fine the way he is.
I think he even changed out of those things on the journey. How are you gonna impress a classy girl like Michelle?
I'm easily impressed.
I know you are, sweetie. And I just don't get it. Thanks for the lift, Niko.
Yeah. Thanks. Give me a call sometime.
See you soon, Michelle.
Well, easy mission there.
Cousin, I dropped the girls off. A friend gave me her number, but I don't think Mallory likes my clothes so much.
I know just the place for you. It's on Mohawk Street Hall. Go and get something a bit more 21st century.
So the next mission is literally just go buy some clothes. Literally. Yeah. Not much to say about that. I wish I could have the music on, because that's usually what I do when I play GTA, is I just listen to the music, but, well, can't do that. It's copyrighted. Buy clothes from various shops throughout Liberty City. Okay, so literally all you have to do is buy jeans. You don't have to like get anything special here. Buy pants. That should be enough to impress Michelle. Should be. Seems like she's very easily impressed. Definitely keep dating her. I haven't even dated her yet. You can place a waypoint on the map, and a GPS route will be displayed to that icon. Well, I mean, if that isn't already self-explanatory already. Literally telling people how to play the game, like, as if they've never played the game before. I sometimes think that's hilarious.
Michelle?
I don't normally do this, but I thought you'd probably be pretty lonely having just moved to Liberty City and all.
You do not normally do what?
You're not making this easy for me, are you? I'm asking you out on a date.
I am sorry. I am still not used to how things work here in America. A date would be good. I am getting sick of hanging out with Roman all the time. How about I pick you up from your apartment?
That sounds good. See you soon.
Alright, so, got a date, and, yeah. Alright, let's do this.
Come and bite this punk chihuahua!
Aside from that, you don't actually have to take people out on dates or whatever. It's not actually mandatory for this storyline. This one is, just so that it introduces you to that, like, way of things. But then there's also an option, like, later on. Just, like, giving a second tree, there's an option. Kind of. Yep.
Niko, please
don't
hide any corners in the court. How do
you... What does he want, say?
Oh, I can't think what he can possibly want. Otherwise he'd be pissed off, can you? Come on, guys. Let's be reasonable.
Alright, so now you have a choice between two missions. Go on a date or help Roman's useless ass, so... I'm gonna help Roman, otherwise he complains and bitches at you about that, so... Let's just kinda go do that now. Also, this mission is a bit more action-oriented than the date one.
Thanks.
Roman, rescue, Roman. Yeah, I'm kind of doing that. I'm a shitty driver. It's also, I guess, I'm not 100% used to the GTA 4 controls. Especially considering how the cars are really weird in this one. I guess they were like experimenting with something or whatever when it comes to controls. Alright, so now I gotta go beat up some dudes. Like, late at night, gotta go beat up some dudes in a basketball court.
Listen, Daddy is a good friend of mine. It was a misunderstanding.
No! Hey! Shit! That is! Keep him fat boy here and I'll talk to him. Our problems with your cousin.
I told you to stop. Now it's too late.
Get close to him, stupid.
You want to make this get really nasty?
Oh, God.
If I wasn't a pacifist, I'd stick it to you, too. You shouldn't have messed with the bellies.
Oh, shit. Niko's got the moves, man.
You all right, cousin?
Yeah. Fine. Fucking loan sharks, man. If one more of these gangsters tries to... Speaking of shitheads, here's Darden. Come on,
huh?
My car is over there. Let's get him. You drive. I don't feel so good.
Car chase time.
Get up!
Alright, go chase down this dude. And since I fucked up the other car, Roman's car should be just fine. Roman, get your fat ass over here. Come on. Alright, let's go.
These guys think that they're better than me. They think they can fuck me around and beat me up because there are more of them. Not any longer. Me and you, Niko. Me and you are going to show them. Fucking dirt and smash my fucking stuff. Who does he think he is? Just some fucking...
Here's the thing, the chase scenes don't actually go all that fast, just because if you do, it would be almost impossible to turn a corner, especially if it's a sharp turn. So, a lot of chase scenes, you don't end up going all that fast, just because of that. Basically, just chase down this guy, beat the shit out of him, then you can go out on a date with Mallory. Just because, yeah. Fuck. Why does it keep zooming up on the bumper? What the hell?
He's trying to get away on foot!
Come on, stop. Alright. It's above or below, blah, 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 blah. Alright, so, basically, I believe if you beat him up a proper way, you also get the knife.
You broke my arm already, man!
I'm everywhere.
Your cousin owes us money! Shit!
Oh my god, this is bad. Oh god, he keeps stabbing me. Come on.
Ah!
actually, like, kick his ass. What the hell? Oh, well. Let's do this. Try it again. Fuck, where's it gonna put me? Fuck, I gotta go all the way over there. Oh, you know what? Actually, it's not too far away, and then his car's gonna be there, so... I'm gonna go beat up those guys again. I'm actually used to the GTA 5 one. Like, you don't have to press, like, circle to punch and stuff. You can literally just hold L2 and mash L2 just to beat the shit out of somebody.
Listen, Dad, he's a good friend of mine!
Skip this shit. Alright.
Back off!
Come on. Come on. Okay. Don't hit me, ass white. Come on. Come on. Come here. Fuck you, fuck you. Fuck you, fuck you, fuck you, fuck you.
This meeting is for Darden!
Oh, fuck yourselves. Yeah. Don't fuck with Niko.
You alright, cousin?
Alright, let's go. Go chase after Darden, and then go kick his fucking ass. For the last time. Roman! Hurry the fuck up! Get in here. Alright, let's go. You could just skip this bit and go all the way straight to, like, the point where I fucked up and got killed, rather than have to beat up those two guys and do the whole chase scene all over again. I think that's why I like GTA 5 a bit more, because they do that whole retry mission and usually puts you back to where you fucked up. I like that better than the way this one, but this is still a good game, so I guess that's why I decided to do a let's play of this one. This is technically my first Let's Play, but I have tried in the past. It failed horribly just because of the fact that I was filming everything off of my BlackBerry, so it was a piece of shit. So, this one's a bit better quality. Alright. Go kick Darden's ass. For the last time! Hey, buddy. Come on.
Your brother.
Oh, there's what we owe you, Darden. Nothing else.
Get up. Pretty sure if you go up to him, you get the knife. Or not, because the knife fell in the water. Okay, well, still gotta find a way back to Roman's car just so I can drive him home or whatever. Usually you can get the knife from that, but I guess I fucked up somewhere and punched him out the window, and now he dropped it in the water, so... Whatever, I'll get weapons at some point soon.
Darden ain't a problem for you no more, cousin.
Nice one, cousin. Drive back to the depot. These bruises are starting to pain.
Woo!
Yes!
I'm being a psycho!
I'm being a psycho, well.
These men, these Sherlocks like Darden, always try to squeeze you for everything. A man in Europe, another Russian. Bulgarian. He lived on the Adriatic. Believed that I owed him money when I did not. It made my life impossible. There was no avoiding him.
Did you deal with him like you did Darden and Bleeder?
He had too many connections for that. I had to leave. He is one of the reasons I came here.
And to see you, cousin, of course.
Of course.
We will have no more problems from now on, cousin. It is all plain sailing straight to the top for you and me.
We will see if things are that simple.
Alright, so I got a text from Mallory asking what the hell happened, why I flake on her.
Thank you, cousin. I'll see you later.
Of course you will, because you'll have a shit ton of missions for me where all I do is drive people around. How exciting! It's usually like a Strangers and Freaks mission or whatever it's called. It's like a buddy mission. Where a guy literally just gives you $100. Or maybe he's not here during the night. Huh. So that $100 comes in very handy later on, because you don't get money as easily. Well, I'm gonna go to the save host and save, and that'll pretty much be it for this part. I hope this video was a bit more exciting than the last video. The last video was literally just introducing the game and just, you know, introducing all the characters, so I hope this one was a bit more exciting and more entertaining than the first one, so, yeah. Hope you all enjoyed the video. We'll be sure to make it a weekly thing, and maybe sometime later this week there'll be another video, which is gonna be online multiplayer of, like, COD 4 or something. So yeah, thank you very much for watching, and have a good day.